Hello, 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 everyone, and welcome, welcome. Today, I want to really dive into something that has been on my mind a lot lately, and that's perfectionism. I hear from so many people, and I also see it. So many people are just obsessed with being perfect. And today, I want to really address that because there is no such thing as perfection. Perfection is just a disguise for your fear of something, whatever that is. And this year, I'm really focusing on mindset. And I've talked a little bit about fixed mindset and growth mindset. And really the fixed mindset is really the ones that have that fear of perfection, that thing inside of them that they can't get past. And I really want us to focus this year on really changing our mindset and getting rid of that idea of perfection. Because once you start grasping that perfection is not realistic, that it's actually holding you back from your fullest potential, once you grasp that, you can start growing then. You can start learning more. You can start becoming better than you are now. And I think that's really, really important that we work on that really a whole lot this year. So see, perfection is never achievable. That's one thing. You can never achieve perfection. There is really no such thing. It's the fear of something, like I said just a few minutes ago. And it's really important that you sit down and you try to figure out what that fear is that you have. It can be something little. It could be something big. And then it's really about that fixed mindset. I've talked a lot about fixed versus growth, and that your fixed mindset, and a lot of times, let me preface this by saying, you know, people have asked me before, I don't think I'm one or the other. And actually, that's probably true. You're probably going to be not necessarily the middle of the fence or on the fence. You're probably going to be a little bit off the fence one way or the other. And maybe some aspects of your life, you're going to be more towards the fixed or the growth. And sometimes you're going to be more towards that fence. But leaning more towards the fixed mindset is that fear of failure, that fear of needing to be perfect. And so what I'm going to challenge you to do this year, or actually this quarter. So we are halfway through January, and I want to challenge you to pick 5 things that you'd really love to fail at. And I'm putting the word fail in there, not to say you're not going to achieve anything, but to go ahead and get that out of your mind that you need to be perfect at it. I want you to have fun. I want you to pick 5 things that you're going to put in your mind. I want to try to fail at these. And the reason I'm saying that is because that gives you permission to enjoy what you're doing. A couple of years ago, I had a lady in one of my workshops, and I said the same thing to them. I'm like, what have you failed at lately? And she said, belly dancing. She said, I really, really, really wanted to learn belly dancing. And I went to a class and I said, how'd you do? And she started laughing and she said, I was horrible. And I said, are you going to go back? And she said, absolutely, I'm going to go back, because it was one of the most fun times I've ever had. I laughed and laughed and laughed. And she goes, I'm okay with being a horrible belly dancer because it was so much fun. And she was going to keep doing it, not to get perfect, but because she enjoyed the process. So if you're one of these people that have this fear and you have this urge that you must be perfect all the time, then pick 5 small things that you can fail at and attempt those, do those, and remember to laugh and enjoy the process. Okay, before we get into Q&A, I wanted to let you guys know I'm going to be doing another one of my workshops in my 4-part motivation series, and that's coming up this Friday, January 22nd from 10 to 11:30 a.m. It's the energy component in motivation. And then in 2 weeks, I'll be February 5th, I'll be doing What Role Direction Plays, and on the 19th, I'll be hosting Persistence is Key. These will be taught through js101.org/workshops, where you can go and register. They are free to the public. So I hope that you join me there. And I'll put this on my Facebook page as well. But yes, I hope that you join me there. The energy component is not what you think about. We're really going to talk about the things that really zap that energy out of you. And it's all about your mind. And it all goes back to mindset. And this affects your motivation. So I really, really, really hope that you join me on the last three. There are four in the series that I just finished doing 2 weeks ago, mindset, delving into mindset, self-esteem, and self-confidence. So I hope you join me there. Okay. Now, for those that want to look for more of my resources, you can find me on my website at thesocialatelier.com as well. My main website is sandy-adams.com, and you can find me on Facebook and Instagram at Official Sandy Adams. So enough of that. So now back to question number one from one of my followers. And that question is from Lisa. And Lisa said, I want to get started on LinkedIn. What is the first thing that I need to do? Lisa, great question. We're all intimidated by that starting off on something new. And what I would tell you ahead of time is to sit down. You need to have a good profile picture. So go ahead and get that out, preferably a headshot that can be cropped into a circle, and they'll crop it inside the platform. You need to also sit down and think of five keywords that people would use to find you. Now, I see a lot of people that put on LinkedIn, mother, husband, wife, those kind of things. People are not going to search for that on LinkedIn. Your keywords are your headline right underneath your name. And so those are where you're going to put the words that people would search to find you. For me, I have photographer, I have social media brand strategist, podcast host, portrait photography, speaker, motivation speaker. Those are the things I have under mine because that's what people would type in to find me. And that's what I want them to type in to find me. Okay. So then after you get the keywords, you need to think about your about section and or your summary section. I forget what it's called. And this is where you sit down and you really think about who you are, what you've done, and where you want to go. And those are really three good questions to answer in paragraph form and get started on that about section. And then you want to sit down and you want to look at the last 10 years of employment, and you want to put that down. And for each one of your places of work, whatever you've done, whether it's been a business or an actual job for somebody else, you also want to think about the value and what your achievements were at each job, not just your duties. You want to think about what you achieved. And if you can have numbers associated with that, like my work with the Heart Association, over the past 20 years, I have helped them raise over $1 million. That is something that tells about my work with them, and it gives a number so people have some type of perception. So I hope that helps with that. And also, you want to start networking with people and start connecting with the people that you already know and you've worked with and you want to get to know better. So I hope that helps you kind of narrow those down. The next one is from Jesse. And Jesse says, how can I stand apart on LinkedIn from everybody else? So Jesse, I'm going to give you a suggestion. And everybody most people put in the stuff on their profile sections and that kind of thing. And they connect with people, and some people post and some people don't. And some people are not good at posting and they don't know what to talk about. You want to educate people on your, you want to educate followers and people that you're connecting with and people that may come across your page as to what you do. But one way you could stand out on your profile section is to do a video, a really maybe a 30-second video or maybe a minute about who you are, what you've done, and what value you bring to people. Maybe talk about things that you've accomplished. Think of it as a video resume. Do that and attach it inside up at the top of your profile. And that will also give people another idea of who you are. It'll make you more dimensional and it will stand you apart from everybody else. So I hope that helps you. Okay, guys, that's it for today. Just another reminder about my workshops coming up. They're free to the public. this coming Friday from 10 to 11:30, the energy component. February 5th, same time, what role direction plays. And February 19th, persistence is the key. I will be putting those into my Facebook page in the events section so you can follow me. If you have questions, do not hesitate to send them to me. I'm happy to try and answer those live in the next few episodes. I'll be back next Wednesday with another Ask Me Anything session and have a little conversation with you. So that's it for today, guys. Have a fantastic rest of the day.